Welcome to Learn Instrumentation Engineering YouTube channel. Today we are going to see what is basically an equipment stop and equipment trip. Recently I had a common questions from our subscribers regarding whether there is any difference between stop and trip is available or not related to an equipment. So in this video, we would be detailedly discussing on what is basically an equipment stop and an equipment trip. So please watch this video to have a better understanding on this philosophy. And in our YouTube channel, Learn Instrumentation Engineering, we are covering basic concepts and fundamentals of instrumentation and control systems. We do cover latest technological updates, which is happening in and around globally on instrumentation engineering. Also, we will cover latest technical news as well. So if you are an instrumentation student or instrumentation engineer or even an expert in this field, kindly subscribe to our channel to gain more knowledge. So let's get into this video. What is basically an equipment stop and equipment trip? So let's detailly see how an equipment stop and equipment trip is different from each other. For example, I am having a vessel or a tank, and from the tank bottom I am taking a suction line which is getting into a pump, okay, and this pump is discharging the fluid. So basically, let's take this as an equipment over here, okay. This pump is an equipment. So we shall detailly discuss how equipment stop and equipment trip is classified in this particular pump equipment. Okay. So if you go to the pump area, we would be having a local control panel nearby the pump. Okay. So it is basically a local control station. So what are all the functions which would be available in this local control panel is, local remote selection key would be available, start stop button would be available, and emergency push button would be available. So if an area operator wants to start this particular equipment in the field locally by himself, he will turn on this local selection and he'll give a start button so that the pump will start running. And the same area operator can give a stop command from this local control panel and can stop this pump equipment. So this is basically a local start stop function. So this is a normal start and stop function. Similarly, we do have a remote start, remote stop function. So what is basically remote start and remote stop? If the local selection is changed to remote selection, the pump equipment cannot be started in locally, whereas it can be started from DCS or PLC or any other control system only from the control room or panel operator room. For example, in this case, I have taken this particular remote selection in DCS. So from control room, we can give a remote start and remote stop. So you could see over here an equipment stop is classified as locally we can start and stop an equipment, and remotely we can start and stop an equipment. The main point over here is, when you stop it from locally or stop it from remote DCS, the equipment available is always ensured to be okay. See, the equipment availability is always okay. For example, I can give n number of start and n number of start from local or remote, and still the pump equipment will be available for our demand. This is basically an equipment stop. I will explain this very clearly in the trip scenario. Okay. Now, what is basically trip? In the same example, this pump equipment is having a local control panel or local control station, and here we are having an emergency push button. If the area operator sees any process upset or any other abnormality which is happening in the field, he can immediately press this emergency push button, and that would initiate an equipment trip through this local emergency push button. Local stop is different and local emergency trip is now different. I will tell you what it is. Similarly, from remote, so for example, the area operator is not available in the field and there is some emergency shutdown trip command is activated, then also this equipment will get into trip. So what are would be the basic ESD trips? That might be some process upset or electrical fault. So that will include like earth fault, overload, etc. And that might be any FNG alarms or FNG trips, any confirmed fire, confirmed gas release conditions. So these scenarios will initiate an ESD trip, and that ESD trip will trip this particular pump equipment. Now, in both the local emergency push button trip or ESD trip, we have the equipment availability to be not okay. So if an equipment trips, the equipment availability will be not okay. There will be, you cannot start this particular equipment again without normalizing the ESD trip. There are two things we have to do once an equipment trip. We have to normalize or make the ESD healthy. Okay. For example, if any process high, for example, if any process high initiated ESD trip, then you have to normalize this PSHH to its normal operating condition. Then only the ESD trip will become healthy. Okay. And the second thing we have to do is we have to reset the ESD trip. So what is basically reset? The area operator or control room operator is acknowledging that all process conditions and safety conditions are okay in the field. So this particular equipment can be started. It can be retrieved from this trip condition. So once reset is done, we would be having permissive to start this particular equipment. So now you have seen that equipment stop and equipment trip are not same, both are different. So in stop condition, pump or in any equipment can be started and stopped n number of times, but at the same time equipment availability will be always okay, you can start the equipment. But in trip condition, it might be a local emergency push button trip or an ESD trip, the equipment availability will become not okay unless we have to normalize the equipment trip or we have to make the ESD healthy, and then we have to do a reset functions. Then only this trip will get normalized, we can start the pump again. So in this particular video, you would have got a detailed understanding of equipment stop and trip. So if this video was very useful to you, please hit the like button and share to instrumentation community. If you want to watch such instrumentation video, do subscribe to our YouTube channel, Learn Instrumentation Engineering. Thank you.